This week at Interior. A proposal released this week for the next 5 years of oil and gas drilling on the nation's outer continental shelf. Secretary Jewell calls it a balanced proposal that protects sensitive resources and supports safe and responsible development of the nation's domestic energy resources to create jobs and reduce our dependence on foreign oil. You can find the entire plan at DOI.gov. The Secretary this week also announced a milestone for commercial wind energy development. The Bureau of Ocean Energy Management has defined a wind energy area of more than 81,000 acres for possible development 11 miles south of Long Island. Visit DOI.gov to learn more. Secretary Jewell in Liberty, Texas this week to help dedicate the Palmer Bayou Boardwalk at the Trinity River National Wildlife Refuge. Joining the Secretary, AFL-CIO President and Union Sportsman Alliance Chairman Richard Trumka, the new boardwalk traverses more than 500 feet of wetlands and connects the refuge to Liberty's existing 13-mile trail system. Secretary Jewell visiting Channel Islands National Park this week to highlight the conservation success story of three subspecies of fox. Last month, the Fish and Wildlife Service announced a proposal to delist the foxes, which would be the fastest successful recovery for any mammal on the endangered species list. The Secretary also handed out every kid in a park passes to more than 90 fourth graders, giving them and their families free access to America's public lands and waters. Thanks to 24 years of recovery efforts, the Louisiana black bear will be removed from the federal list of endangered and threatened wildlife. The bear became part of American folklore after President Theodore Roosevelt refused to shoot one during a 1902 hunting trip, hence the now famous moniker Teddy Bear. The next two cities have been announced to join the First Lady's and Interior's Let's Move Outside 50 Cities initiative. Tampa, Florida and Birmingham, Alabama, now part of the effort to engage the next generation of outdoor stewards and inspire millions of young adults to play, learn, serve and work in the great outdoors. For the full list, check out DOI.gov. The Bureau of Safety and Environmental Enforcement doing its part to promote STEM education. Bessie hosted the inaugural High School Offshore Technology Stars Challenge at the University of Houston. 120 local students took part, designing and building energy harvesting electrical circuits to power remote control helicopters, which were then flown around a challenge course. The top scoring students were awarded $10,000 and educational grants for their schools. Lots of wooden bridges took one for the team at the Bureau of Reclamation's Denver Laboratory, and it's all for a good cause. 70 students taking part in the 49th annual Colorado High School Bridge Building Competition. The winners took home scholarships and a ticket to the International Bridge Building Competition in Chicago. That's this week at Interior.